Hello students, today we are going to see the topic work measurement and Dr. K. Kalidas to handle the session for you. So work measurement is the application of technique designed to establish the time for a qualified worker to carry out specific jobs at a defined level of performance. So he is a quality worker. For doing a particular job, he is taking some time. So what is that time taken? So that we are going to measure. So that is nothing but the work measurement. So it determines the time required to do a job. What is the manpower required to do a job? What is the equipment requirement to do a job? And it provides the information for production planning and maintenance. It helps in calculating the exact delivery date. It decides the labor budgeting and standard costing system. It provides a base for incentive scheme. It results in an effective labor control. What are its components? The first one is element. Again, it's a part of a specified job which is taken for analysis. Then performance rating is the judgment of the performance of the labor. Allowances is the time period given for a labor to recover from fatigue and to attend to personal needs. Standard time under working condition. What is the time taken by an average worker working at an average speed? So it is given as a standard. So what are the types of elements? So one is repetitive elements. So for all the jobs and for all the times that you do a job, this element, it works on all work cycles. Occasional element, it happens in intervals. It doesn't happen often. Then constant element, so it is the time period happen continuously over a longer period of time. So it occurs in a constant time period for every 5 minutes, for every 10 minutes, for every 2 minutes, like that. For a constant time period, this element will occur. The variable time period means according to the operating conditions, dimensions and weight, etc., the variation in the element takes. So that's the manual element, so the work performed by a worker. Machine element, again to a machine. In governing element, so it is the maximum time occurring element which is more important in a job. Foreign element, just for analysis purpose, we'll be using some elements, and after analysis, we are not going to use it for the original. Say, for example, a prototype. It's a foreign element. So, how your performance rating can be a standard rating. So, it gives you the rating with respect to the job that is being done. And normal rating is the rating based on speed, skill, effort, Westinghouse system, synthetic, objective, and as well as physiological rating. Say, for example, speed rating can be calculated as observed time into speed of the worker by expected speed of the expected speed at which the worker has to be working. Similarly, how much skill and effort he is going to. The Westinghouse of system is given with a number system called B numbers. For every B amount of work, what is the point that he has obtained? So that's a kind of system called a Westinghouse system. So similarly, all those rating systems are being used. Then allowances, again, the resting period or the period of relieving from fatigue is called as the allowance. So it's called as process allowance. in compensation, time, concerning the idleness due to the character of the process. Because of the process, the worker is idle. Personal and rest allowances, again due to fatigue, physical and psychological needs, some allowances can be given. Then special allowances like setting of a tool, cleaning of a machine. So to calculate the standard time, so standard time is nothing but the basic time plus allowances. So basic time is observed time into observed level of performance time, desired level of performance or observed rating divided by the standard rate. So how this work measurement technique works? Again, we are going to use time study for recording and analyzing the time and speed of the worker. Then synthesis from the standard data, comparing the standard data with the performance of the worker. Then PMTS. So as micro study and macro study, we are going to analyze the motion of the labor. Then analytical estimation or estimating. So for long and non-repetitive jobs, how he performs. Then work sampling, taking a proportion of the labor work using sampling techniques. So these are the work measurement techniques that will be used in the industrial engineering. So in this lecture, we have seen about the objectives, component types, and the techniques used in the work management. Thank you.